Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is a quick trick on how to find top 10 products in Power BI. I mention N here since this N can be replaced by any number. It can be top 3, top 100, or top 50, whatever, based on the business scenario. Let's explore top 10 based on our Naga Garments scenario. The Naga Garments is owning a men's casual wear. He's selling ladies casual and some accessories. And he wants to find the top 3 products. These are categories. Underneath, you have around 10 to 15 products. And in this case, instead of top 10, we will find top 3 products that this Naga Garment is selling. And based on that, how we will get benefited. Since in future months, he wants to purchase more on what are the top 3 products selling in his garment shop. With this note, let's jump into demo how to find top 3 products. Heading to our Power BI desktop, I hope people will know about how to create this simple chart like item name and item amount. Only two things I have used here to analyze. So in this, he has very few items, so that's why I didn't go for top 10. So for Naga Garments, we will have only the top 3 items. Viewing it here itself, you can find these are the top 3 items, right? But assume like you have hundreds and 200s of items, they want to find top 50. In that case, it becomes very difficult. So in those cases, you will go for this option. For understanding purpose, we will restrict to top 3. So how to create that? So click on this chart, then go to filters, and you see here item name and item amount. These are the two things you have used. What you want to see as a top 3, you want to see the top 3 item or products, right? So navigate to down, and you see in filter type you have different options. Usually it will be basic filtering, and if you choose top n, filter type top n, then here you can mention your n, the replace the n value with whatever value you are based on your business. In this case, I'm going for 3. And these top 3 should be based on what? So item amount over here, it can be anything, okay? Based on item quantity also I can put. For simplicity, we go for item amount again. So you need to put explicitly here once again. For total sales wise, item amount wise, I want top 3 product selling. So this is what you are mentioning here. Then click apply filter. So it's a magic. So I got top 3 selling products here, and as I said, it is as simple as that, guys. So no coding. Once again, in Power BI, you no need to do any coding. Now, as I said, you have some surprise or bonus. Let's see what it is. When I want to choose Bangalore, it is same. I mean, these are the top 3 products, but when I choose Chennai, you can see like instead of some other item, jeans, denim, in Chennai, my top second item is shirt, arrow shirt. Okay, that is what's one of the insight he's able to find. Whereas in Hyderabad, it is again jeans, denim. So in Bangalore and Hyderabad, it's the same. Whereas in Chennai, shirt, arrow. So using this kind of analysis, instead of blindly going for all the top 3 products investing for future purchase, he can go and specific to each location, he can purchase top 3 products. If it is in Bangalore, then these are the 3 items he has to purchase more. If it is in Chennai, then he should purchase shirt, arrow, jeans, denim, jeans, levis, instead of blindly going and purchasing the top 3 items. I hope this video is helpful to you guys as well as for this Naga Garments business. If you like this video, comment below and share with your friends and colleagues. And subscribe it if you haven't subscribed it till now. And do remember that data is your asset.